In part one of how to make a seed starting tower with homemade LED grow light panels, we took this small greenhouse and attached it to a dolly to make it mobile. And here it is completely finished. In this video, we're going to show you how to assemble the grow light panels and install them into the greenhouse. This is what a finished panel looks like. And this is what we use to make them. We have 3 5-meter reels of 3528-600 LED IP65 waterproof flexible strip light, each with their own 12-volt 5-amp power supply. And what all those numbers mean is the 3528 are the individual LEDs size. The 600 number is how many LEDs are on the 5-meter strip. And the 5-meter strip is approximately 16 feet 4 inches long. And the IP65 is the waterproof rating. The 6 means dust tight and the 5 means protected against water jets from any angle. We have one reel each of red, white, and blue. We're making 2 panels with red and blue lights and 1 panel with all white lights. We were going to mount the lights to the bottom of an old suspended ceiling tile, and I couldn't find where we put them. So I went to Home Depot and I bought a sheet of this Yucatile, I don't know how you pronounce it, but it comes in a sheet 48 inches by 8 feet long and an 1/8 inch thick. And I got them to cut it for me into 17 by 24 inch panels. The size isn't really matter. None of these measurements really matter because you're probably not going to be doing it the same way I am. One side of this stuff is brown, as you can see here, and the other side is a nice shiny white, which is the side we're going to stick the lights on. And you can see we marked it out, and we're going to put our light strips 2 inches on center. That's what the black lines are. The power supply came with the male end already connected. Each reel of lights came with the red and black wire soldered on, and they were sealed with some shrink tape. The other end of the red and black wires are already stripped, and they supply you with this female screw-on connector. Stick the red wire under the positive terminal, and stick the black wire under the negative terminal, and tighten them up. But before we put the female end on, we cut 4 pieces of shrink tubing, different diameters but the same length, that would fit inside each other, and slid them onto the wires. Then we attached the female end. And the reason we did this was because I wanted to get one of the larger shrink tubes up over the end of that female fitting. And when you shrink it, it won't shrink enough to wrap around the wire. So we put a small one, shrunk it, then slid up the bigger one and shrunk it. Then we shrunk up, then we slid up the biggest one on, actually onto the thing a little bit, and shrunk it. That way it grabbed nice and tight around the wires. And you can see in that last photograph, we didn't slide that last piece of shrink wrap up over the connector enough, and it pulled off when we shrunk it. So we ended up throwing another one on and doing it again. You might not even need to do this step. It was just me being anal. Now, the next part is how to cut them and clip them together. Now it's time to cut your light strips. So when you figure out how long you want them, you get a pair of scissors and cut them. In our case, we're going with 23.5 inches. And there's 2 ways to cut them. You can see there are 4 little copper tabs every inch or so on the strip here. If you're going to solder them, you cut them right in half, right through the middle of the strips like this. So you end up with 2 ends like this. If you're going to use the connectors, they tell you to cut them so you have all 4 tabs on each end. So you, when you mark it all out and cut it, you lose a little bit of the strip. You lose about an inch like this. You can see one all cut. So you have the end of the one end of one on the left, and you have the beginning of the one on the right, and that little strip in the middle is junk. You can't use it because it doesn't have any copper tabs. And that's what happens if you use the connectors the way they tell you to use the connectors. But I ended up doing it, cutting them both ways and still being able to use the connectors. So first I'll show you the proper way that you're going to see everywhere else on the internet. Now that you have them cut to length, take a razor knife and carefully strip off the waterproof coating. And of course, you don't have to do this step if you don't have waterproof LED strips. Here it is with the waterproofing removed. And remember, when you cut your strips to length, write on the backside what color it is, because you can't tell them apart just by looking at them. And we're going to be making red and blue panels, and we want to alternate them. Before you put your strip light into the connector, you need to determine the polarity. And if you look closely in this picture, at the top edge, just to the right of the copper tabs, you'll see a plus 12V. That's the positive side of that strip. The bottom edge is the negative. So when you slide your strip light into the connector, you want that plus 12V side to be going to the terminal that's aligned with the red wire of the connector. Slide it all the way in and snap it. To use the connectors on the ones we cut in half like we were going to solder them, strip the waterproof coating off the two copper tabs on the end. Then slightly bend that end down right next to the LED. And now, looking at this photo of the connector, you can see there are four little pins. Take that end that you just bent down slightly and stick it right in between all four pins. Bend it down a little more and snap it closed. And that's the way we did it on the white ones, and it worked great. We're going to put 8 strips on a panel at 2 inches on center. We stuck all 8 strips together and made sure they worked before we stuck them down to the panels. After they were all together, we took a razor knife and carefully cut the paper on the sticky backing right next to each connector and peeled it off, and then stuck each strip down on the board. Be careful not to twist your wires in the connectors as you put the strips down, or it'll want to come up. That's why we're using the telephone to hold that one down. After you're done, plug it in. You'll probably have one or two of them have come loose. Just reconnect them. That's what we did. Then drill a hole on each side of the light strips, big enough to stick a zip tie through near each connector to stop the light strips from peeling off. Remember, they don't have to be super tight. They're just there to stop the lights from peeling off the board. To attach the panels to the greenhouse, near each corner, we measured in 3/4 of an inch from the edge, and where the lines crossed, we drilled a hole. Then we zip tied the panels to the bottom of shelves in the greenhouse. Right now, 4 zip ties seems to be plenty. If they start to sag in the future, we can add more. Then we attached each panel to its power supply and plugged them in. From what I've read, plants don't need white light. They prefer red and blue spectrums. And we made 2 different color panels because we're going to do an experiment. We're going to start our seedlings now and see if they do any better under the red and blue lights compared to the white light. If they do, I'll take that white light and make some kind of stand for it and use it to light videos. And eventually I'll make a couple or more red and blue panels. I don't even know if these LEDs throw enough light to grow plants under, so you might want to wait for a couple of updates before you go out and build this thing. Now that's it for this one. If you like to, please give it a thumbs up. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. God bless. Bye.